Good morning, my dear children. Welcome back to our English class. So in the last class, we have discussed chapter number 11, a drama, the proposal written by Anton Chekhov. I hope that you all read the lesson and understood the portion that we have taken in the last video. Let's recall your memory on the session that we have taken. So the hero of our drama, Lemov, goes to Chubukov's house in the evening dress to seek Nadalia's hand in marriage. That is, he is wanted to propose Nadalia. Nadalia is the younger doctor of his neighbor, Chubukov. He was a landowner. Then Lemov tells Chubukov the purpose behind his visit, and Chubukov gladly gives his consent to the marriage. Then Nadalia came, and Lemov starts talking of his land that Nadalia says is owned by her. That means their talking is relating with a land called Oxen Meadows. Lemov says how he owns the land, but it is disputed by Nadalia. And they start arguing over the ownership of the land, Oxen Meadows. Okay. Let's continue with the rest of the lesson. Nadalia: it is not true. I will prove it. I will send my mowers out to the meadows this very day. Lemov: what? Nadalia: my mowers will be there this very day. Lemov: I will give it to them in the neck. Nadalia: you dare? Lemov clutches at his heart. Oxen Meadows are mine, you understand, mine. So their argument is again going on, and Nadalia is saying that I will prove that the Oxen Meadows are mine, and I will send my mowers, mowers means workers, out to the meadows this very day. Then Nadalia, Lemov is telling that if you are sending them, I will give it to them, the in the neck means I will beat them. Then Nadalia is again arguing that the meadows are mine. Then Lemov, touching his heart, holding his heart, said that Oxen Meadows are mine. Nadalia: please don't shout. You can shout yourself hoarse in your own house, but here I must ask you to restrain yourself. Lemov: if it wasn't, madam, for this awful excruciating palpitation, if my whole inside wasn't upset, I would talk to you in a different way. Yes, Oxen Meadows are mine. So Nadalia is saying that you have to shut your mouth and your hoyas. Hoyas means loud voice. You can make your loud voice in your own house, but here you must have to ask, restrain yourself means check yourself. Then Lemov is saying that because of the palpitation, already we know that Lemov have the problem of palpitation. So because of this excruciating, that great palpitation which is happening inside my heart, and I was so much upset, otherwise I will talk in a different way. And he else means cried out and loudly that Oxen Meadows are mine. Nadalia: ours? Lemov: mine. Nadalia: ours? Lemov: mine. So again they are arguing about the ownership of the Oxen Meadows. Enter Chubukov. Chubukov: what is the matter? What are you shouting for? Nadalia: papa, please tell this gentleman who owns Oxen Meadows, we or he. Chubukov to Lemov: darling, the meadows are ours. So this time Nadalia's father, Chubukov, enters, and Chubukov asks what was the matter, why they are shouting. Then Nadalia is saying that you have to tell this gentleman that who was the owner of Oxen Meadows, we or he. Then Chubukov tell to Lemov that Oxen Meadows are theirs. Okay. Lemov: but please, Stepan Stepanovich, how can they be yours? Do be a reasonable man. My own grandmother gave the meadows for the temporary and free use of your grandfather's peasants. The peasants used the land for 40 years, and got accustomed to it as if it was their own when it happened that. Chubuko, excuse me, my precious, you forgot just this, that the peasants didn't pay your grandmother and all that, because the meadows were in dispute and so on. And now everybody knows that they are ours. It means that you haven't seen the plan. Lemo, I will prove to you that they are mine. Chubuko, you won't prove it, my darling. Lemo, I shall. So, Lemo and Chubuko started to argument the ownership of Oxen Meadows. Lemo is again saying that his aunt's grandmother gave the meadows for the temporary and free use of Chubuko's grandfather's peasants, and the peasants used the land for 40 years and they were accustomed. Accustomed means habitually using to it, and it was their ownership. Then Chubuko is saying that that was not like that. It was ours land. The land was in a dispute and the peasants are not paying for your grandmother. The Lemo saying that I can prove that it was mine. Then Chubuko is saying that you can't prove it, my darling. Then Lemo is again says that I shall prove it, that the land was mine. Okay. Chubuko, dear one, why yell like that? You won't prove anything just by yelling. I don't want anything of yours and don't intend to give up what I have. Why should I? And you know, my beloved, that if you propose to go on arguing about it, I would much sooner give up the meadows to the peasants than to you there. Lemo, I don't understand. How have the right to give away somebody else's property? So Chubuko is saying that, why are you shouting? Why are you shouting like this? Yelling means shouting. And I don't want anything of yours, and also I am not ready to give something that I owns. And if you are making the argument, I will give this meadows to peasants. Then Lemo is saying that, I don't understand how you can give somebody else property to someone. Chubuko, you may take it that I know whether I have the right or not, because young man, I am not used to being spoken to it that tone of voice and so on. I, young man, I'm twice your age and ask you to speak to me without agitating yourself and all that. And for that, Chubuko is giving the reply that I know whether I have the right or not for giving that to the peasants, because I'm not used to being spoken in that tone. And I am twice of your age also. Chubuko is saying that he was twice of your age, so you have to speak without agitating, without irritating yourself, without making angry in yourself. Lemo, no, you just think I am a fool and want to have me on. You call my land yours and then you want me to talk to you calmly and politely. Good neighbors don't behave like that, Stepan Stepanovich. You are not a neighbor, you are a grabber. So Lemo is again arguing that, and he is saying that I am not a fool and you call my land as yours. You are saying that my land is yours, and also you wanted to me to speak in a very calm and polite way. And good neighbors never behave like this, and I am not considering that you are a good neighbor. You are a grabber. Grabber means a person is grabbing somebody else's property. Okay. Chubuko, what is that? What did you say? Nadalia, Papa, send the mowers out to the meadows at once. Chubuko, what did you say, sir? Natalia, Oxen Meadows are ours and I shan't give them up, shan't give them up, shan't give them up. Lemo, we will see. I will have the matter taken to court and then I will show you. Chubuko, to court? You can take it to court and all that you can. I know you. You are just on the lookout for a chance to go to court and all that. So Chubukov is saying that, what did you say? Are you calling me a grabber? Then Natalia is saying to his father that we can send the workers to the meadows. Then Natalia is strongly saying that meadows are ours and we will not give them to you. Then Lemov is declaring that we will see and I will take this matter to court. Then Chubukov is telling that you can take it to court and that the only thing you can do, and I know that you are just lookout, you are just thinking or you are just searching for a chance to go to court. You petty fogger, all your people were like that, all of them. And Chubukov is saying that whenever you got a matter, you are ready to go to court, and he calls Lemo as a petty fogger. Petty fogger here means a clever, crafty man, and he knows that all of his people were like that. Lemo, never mind about my people. The Lemos have all been honorable people, and not one has ever been tried for embezzlement like your grandfather. And Lemo is saying that, never mind about my people. You are not right to tell about my people. And all my people are honorable men, and not one has ever been tried for embezzlement. Embezzle means money losers like your grandfather. Embezzlement means money losers like your grandfather. Chubukov, you Lemos have had lunacy in your family, all of you. Natalia, all. And Chubukov is saying that there are lots of lunacy. Lunacy means smart people. Are there in your family? Then Natalia agrees that Lemo's family have some lunatic people. Chubukov, your grandfather was a drunkard. And your younger aunt Nadasa Mikhailovna ran away with an architect and so on. And Chubukov is telling the people, the relatives of Lemo, and your grandfather was a drunkard, and your younger own Nadasia Mikhailovna ran away with an architect. Then for that, Lemov is also giving some mention about some of the family members of Chubukov's family, Lemov. And your mother was humbacked, clutches at his heart. Something pulling in my side, my heart, help, water. And Lemov is telling that Chubukov's mother was a humbacked person. Humbacked means a person who is having some curve at the back. And he clutches, he touches his heart, and she is saying that something is pulling in my side, my heart, I need water. That means the palpitation, the heart beating is starting in his heart. Chubukov, your father was a guzzling gambler. And Chubukov is saying that your father was a guzzling gambler. Gambler who drinks. Gambler means a person who is gambling with money. And your father was a guzzling gambler means a gambler who drinks a lot. Natalia, and there haven't been any backbiters to equal your aunt. And Natalia is saying that there is no one to equalize with your aunt who was a backbiter. Backbiter means those speaking ill of others behind their backs. Some people who are talking ill of others. That means talking some gossips when the persons are not there. So your aunt was not equalized for any backbiters. Okay. Before explaining the next section, dear children, please notice that some of your textbook, the next character who is speaking is Chubukov, is there in your textbook, some of your textbook. So you have to change the character to Lemo. Okay. Lemo, my left foot has gone to sleep. You are an intriguer. Oh, my heart. And it is an open secret that before the last elections you bribe. I can see stars. Where is my hat? And Lemo is saying that my left foot has gone to sleep means that he has some problems with his foot, and you are an intriguer. At the same time, he is calling Chubukov as an intriguer. Intriguer means a great planner. And at the same time, his heart is beating very heavily, and he is starting to tell something about the election, but he can, and he is saying that I can see stars and where is my heart. That means he want to go out because of this palpitation. Natalia, it is low, it is dishonest, it is mean. And Natalia is saying that you are telling some lawless, dishonest matters. Then Chubuko, and you are just a malicious, double-faced interviewer. Yes, and Chubukov is saying that you are an illful, double-faced interviewer, a planner. Lemo, here is my heart, which way? Where is the door? Oh, I think I am dying, my foot's quite numb. Then Lemo found his heart there, and he is saying that my heart is again beating, and I want to go out where was the door, and I think I am dying. And my foot is quite numb. Numb means senseless. That means his foot is not in a proper way. He was not walking in a proper way. And he goes to the door. Chubuko, following him. And don't set foot in my house. And when Lomau is going out of the room, Chubuko follows him and says that not ever enter into my house. Natalia, take it to court, we will see. And Natalia is calling out and saying that you can take that matter to court. Then Lemo staggers out. And Chubukov is saying that devil take him, walks about in excitement. And Chubukov is also cursing Lemo. Okay, and Lemo walk out from the scene. Natalia, what a rascal. What trust can one have in one's neighbors after that? Chubuko, the villain, the scarecrow. Natalia, the monster. First he takes our land and then he has the impudence to abuse us. So after Lemo went out, Natalia and Chubuko is calling him some names like rascal, scarecrow, villain, and how can we trust our neighbors? And Natalia is saying that he was a monster and first he takes our land and he had the impudence. Impudence means arrogance. Arrogance to abuse us. He is cursing us. Chubuko. And that blind hen. Yes. That turnip ghost has the confounded cheek to make a proposal. And so on. But a proposal. And Chubuko is again cursing him and he is calling him like a blind man. Blind hen. Then turnip ghost. These are all words. Confounded cheek. These are all words which are using for abusing some person. Okay. So here Chubukov is abusing him by calling so much names. And he is saying that person has came here for a proposal. And what a proposal. Then only Natalia is understood that Lemov is came there for proposing her. Then Natalia. What proposal? Chubuko, why? He came here to propose to you. Natalia, to propose to me. Why didn't you tell me so before? Chubuko, so he dresses up in the evening clothes, the stuffed sausage, the wizened face, the frump. So Natalia is bewildered, surprised to hear that Lemovis came there for proposing her. And she is asking her, father, why you are not telling me before that? And Chubuko is saying that is why he was dressed up in the evening clothes. And again he is cursing. Again he is abusing Chubuko by calling stuffed sausage and wizened faced frump. So then only that Natalia knows that Lemo came here there for proposing her. Natalia, to propose to me? Oh, falls into an easy chair and wails. Bring him back. Oh, bring him here. Chubuko, bring whom here? Natalia, quick, I am ill, fetch him. Hysterics. Chubuko, what is that? What is the matter with you? Clutches at his head. Oh, unhappy man that I am. I will shoot myself. I will hang myself. We have done for her. Natalia, I am dying. Fetch him. Chubuko, tough, at once don't yell, runs out a pose. Natalia,
Natalia Stepanova wails. What have they done to me? Fetch him back, fetch him. A pause, Chubukov runs in. Chubukov. He is coming and so on, devil take him. Kuf, talk to him yourself. I don't want to. Natalia wails, fetch him. So when Natalia knows that Chubukov is came therefore to propose her, and she became very irritated and she began to cry. And she is saying that he came to propose me, so you have to go back and fetch him, bring him. And Chubukov is very much wonder, and he is saying that, what is the matter with you? And he touches his head and saying that, I was an unhappy man and I will shoot myself and I will hang myself, and all the thing we have done for her, the quarrel, that argument between them is only for Natalia. But Natalia is saying that, I am dying, you have to fetch him. Fetch him means bring him. Then Chubukov runs out. Then Natalia again wails. Wails means cries. And what have they done to me? Fetch him, fetch him. And she is saying that, I have done something wrong, you have to bring him. Now after a pause, Chubukov runs in. Chubukov came back and he is saying that Lemov is coming and so on, and talk to him yourself. Then Natalia again cries and saying that, fetch him. That means Natalia was in an hysterics mood, in a mad mood, that she is thinking that Lemov was not come. Lemov was not ready to come, but Chubukov goes behind him and he take Lemov to the house again. Chubukov yells, he is coming. I tell you, oh, what a burden load to be the father of a grown-up daughter. I will cut my throat. I will indeed. We cursed him, abused him, drove him out. And it's all you, you. Natalia, no, it was you. Chubukov, I will tell you, I tell you, it is not my fault. Lemov appears at the door. Now you talk to him yourself. Exit. Then hearing the cry of Natalia, Chubukov is yelling. Yells means saying very loudly that he is coming, and what a burden. And he is telling the Lord, telling the God, that it was very difficult to be the father of a grown-up daughter. And we cursed him, we abused Lemo, we cursed abuse, we drove him out of the house. It's only because of you. And Natalia is now saying that, no father, it was you. Then Chubukov is saying that, I tell you, it is not my fault, it is the fault of you. And then Lemo appears at the door, and Chubukov said to his daughter to talk him, and he exits from the scene. So now in the scene, we can see Natalia and Lemov. Okay. Lemov. Lemov enters exhausted. My heart's palpitation awfully. My heart is palpitating awfully. My foot's gone to sleep. There is something that keeps pulling in my side. And when Lemov enters, he is saying that he was in a very exhausted mood, and he is saying that my heart is palpitating, my heart is beating very awfully, and my foot is gone to sleep, my foot are not in a proper way, and there is something that keeps pulling me in my side. Then Natalia, forgive us, Ivan Vasilievich, we were all a little heated. I remember now, Oxen Meadows really are yours. Now, Natalia is saying that you have to forgive us, and we were all a little heated. And I now remember that the Oxen Meadows are yours, Lemov. And now she is admitted that the Oxen Meadows are Lemov's. Okay. Lemov, my heart is beating awfully. My meadows, my eyebrows are both twitching. Natalia, the meadows are yours. Yes, yours. Do sit down. They sit. We were wrong. And Lemov is saying that my heart is beating very awfully. And he is saying that my meadows. And he is also saying that my eyebrows are both twitching. Then Natalia is saying that the meadows are yours. The Oxen Meadows are yours. And you have to sit down. And they together sit. And Natalia is accepting that we were wrong. Lemov. I did it on principle. My land is worth little to me, but the principle. And Lemov is saying that what it I did is on principle, and my land is not a worth little to me. I am not giving any worth to my land, but the principle. Natalia, yes, the principle, just so. Now let's talk of something else. And Natalia is agreeing that that was the right thing. And Lemov is telling that I am telling the ownership of the land on the basis of the rule, principle or rule. And Natalia is now accepting that, yes, you are right, your principle or your rule is right. And now we can talk something else. That means Natalia wanted to change the mood of Lemov. When Lemov is thinking about the oxen meadows, his heart will again palpitating. So Natalia want to change his mood by telling something else. Lemov, the more so as I have evidence, my own grandmother gave the land to your grandfather's peasants. But Lemov is again telling about the oxen meadows, and he is saying that I have the evidence, my own grandmother gave the land to your father's grandfather's peasants. Then Natalia, yes, let that pass aside. I wish I knew how to get him started. Are you going to start shooting soon? So Natalia is agreeing that, yes, I'm agreeing, and let that pass. Pass that matter. You don't tell that matter again. And aside means speaking to herself. I wish I know how to change his mind. I know that how can I will change his mind. And in aloud, she is asking Lemov, are you going to start shooting soon? Are you going to hunting soon? So in this way, Natalia wanted to change the mood of Lemov. So she started to talking about the shooting. That means the hunting. And she is asking Lemov, are you going to start shooting soon? So okay, my dear children, Natalia is ready to accept the proposal of Lemov. That is why she is planning to change the mood of Lemov by asking or by talking something else. So Lemov is, when they are talking about the oxen meadows, again that will end in an argument. So that is why Natalia is agreeing that the oxen meadows are Lemov's. And now she is changing the subject, and she is asking Lemov, where are you planning, or are you going to start shooting soon? Are you ready to go to hunting soon? So in this way, she changes the topic, oxen meadows to hunting. Okay. So, my dear children, let's wind up for today, and we will know in the next class whether Natalia and Lemov proposed each other, and whether they accepted the proposal, or anything other happened, or any other quarrel began in between them. So that we will check in the next class. Okay, my dear children, that is the end of your today's class. You have to read the drama very carefully and try to do the activity questions. We will meet in the next class with the rest of the lesson. Take care. Be happy. Thank you.